just the single. He's got a bit of an issue with his thigh, Pereira, where he got that hit, so he didn't want to come back for the second.
He started to cut loose. Gosal. Seems like he's got his bearing. Started to trust the pitch. He's backing himself to play his strokes now. Worries for Gold Gladiators.
Single. So 13 runs from that first over from Sandakan. 85 for one. He doesn't waste any time, Afridi. Nice to get through those overs nice and quickly. To apply some extra pressure and try and spin through overs in the middle if he can, with he and a spinner at the other end.
He'll be desperate to pick up a wicket here, because this partnership is looking very threatening. 200 once again on the cards.
Extra bounce.
180-190 is bar. Coming in, that's been the trend, and bowlers tend to struggle later. The Gold Gladiators do have a strong batting lineup too, so they shouldn't drop their heads, keep chipping away and focus on damage control.
Airborne, not quite out of the middle, brings the sweeper into play, this time square on the offside.
Russell, with a bit of cloud cover, do you think there are chances of Diora?
That would be maybe not as much as what we have experienced, but enough to make it a little tougher or challenging for the bowlers later on.
Well ball. Toss, can't do too much with that. 97 k's per hour, that delivery from Afridi.
Sometimes way to play Afridi is to treat him like a seam bowler. He's quick. Current run rate 203.
You try and string a couple of tight overs together, the Gold Gladiators. Tuskers are going at over 10 to the opening stage. It's going to be outside the leg, I think. Big shout from Afridi. He thought it was pretty close.
The birthday review. Go upstairs, but I'm with you, Hazy. For a change, we agree.
Have a look. Shahid Afridi was cocksure, but I think the ball pitched on the leg stump. It was a good lead.
Hit him in front, back leg. Did he take the front leg?
Tight over. Three from it so far. Can he finish? If he does, it'll be a big boost, the Gladiators. Smashed on the leg side for four. That's the boundary the Tuskers were looking for. Seven from it, 92 for one.
Spoiled the over. But an opportunity to talk about it. Take a breather, get your strategies right. It's time for the strategic timeout.
Got a boundary off the last ball. Sweeping again. They've brought the sweep out quite a bit today, these two. Partnership now is worth 71 off 41 deliveries.
And as the tournament goes on, Hazy, you'll see that more batsmen will come out with the broom rather than the bat. Spin will come into it, and the sweep is going to be a very effective shot.
Yeah, Mendes has employed it quite efficiently. Has scored plenty of runs in Lanka Premier League so far.
Sensing a real opportunity here for the Tuskers, for the Kandy Tuskers. They've got two guys who are experienced and two guys who certainly know that they need to kick in. Mendes on 44. He's a very, very talented cricketer, and we haven't seen the best of him. Pereer on 27 now. He needs to kick in for mine, and he's a fine player. If he gets himself a big total, that'll get them, I would suggest, very close, if not past the 200 mark. He's moving quickly with his feet. And he's coming back for the second, so that's nicely played and good running as well.
And also in the deep, Gunatilaka on to Shehan Jayasurya, but a few plans. Teams come up with their own little lines that make them tick. Collective decisions there at the back. The Kandy Tuskers, their batting plan, their bowling plan, just put up for reference and a little bit of reminding yourself of what you want to be doing.
That hamstring apparently is not as bad as we thought it was for Irfan Pathan, and he's not going to be too far away from playing again, which is good news.
There we go.
Stay in the zone. Cries of catch it. Is it out? It is out. Throwing the wicket away. It's exactly what I was saying they didn't want to do. Get a start. You've got to capitalize.
That's a brilliant grab, wasn't it? He was running fast, and I thought he overran, but he recovered very quickly, kept the eyes on the ball, and managed to grab onto it. Good take.
Looked like it swung on him, Dhanushka Gunatilaka. Never easy, never easy, but that's a massive blow. He's pulled off a pitch, Dhanushka Gunatilaka, to get rid of Kusal Pereera.
And he's a very good player with a very good record. Just a little bit of a speed wobble, I think, at the end here.
Amazing. Amazing catch. You can't practice those. There we go. I just thought it did swing on Dhanushka Gunatilaka.
Nice and deft. And also fine for four. Off the mark with a boundary. So 9 runs off the over, but also a wicket. 10 overs gone, halfway, 101 for 2.
Ball of last over, the first ball that Brendan Taylor faces. Plays that shot really well. There's a slip in place too, but yet he goes for it.
Come on, boy, come on, boy.
Enough contact. That's a kind of a chance to take very early in your innings. Playing a bit of cricket, been at the PSL, arrived late in the country and available to play today.
Have a look at this. What is the slip fieldsman doing? He hasn't reacted so far. He was in the air.
Oh. Only one.
It only tells you that he's not a regular slipper. He watched it go past and admired it.
He did.
That's Bhanu Rajapaksa, yes. The regular slipper would have anticipated that shot and moved across.
Well ball, standby.
Freddie is doing a good job here. Building pressure into his third over. He's just conceded 15 runs so far.
And if he manages to send Mendes back, there'll be a huge contribution. Because at the moment, he's looking $1 million.
Was that bowled at about 140? Rushed down to Taylor.
Single taken. Just 3 runs. Make that 4 from the over. 105 for 2. Kamundu to come.
Come on.
We see the reverse sweep again. Brendan Taylor very much proficient in playing that shot. Of course, sponsors, very important to any tournament. Red Bull, a major sponsor of this one. A few players getting wings, flying. So Mendes on the cusp of another half century in T20 cricket.
Geez, so much confusion out there. Brilliantly picked up by Afridi on the volley. Has a go at the bowler's end, direct hit. Brendan Taylor's gone. No one backing up, but a fielder in the deep and no single taken. Mendes is on 49 off 29. Gone. This time straight to Afridi, who makes it look so simple. Back-to-back wickets, a second for Lakshan Sandakan.
Regaining territory. Gold Gladiators, they needed a couple of wickets, and the set batsman wicket, they have managed to do so. They are back into this game. Through the left arm, wrist spinner, Sandakan, he's done a good job.
He's batted well though, but out at the wrong time for his team, 49. Tuskers, Candy Tuskers, 106 for 3.
Candy Tuskers will be reflecting on that last dismissal of Kusal Mendes and saying why throw away your innings. He was on the cusp of his 11th T20 half century.
Well, here's a finer point that I'll tell you. Maybe that overthrow should have been taken, an extra effort put in to cross ends. Coming to Mendes, didn't read that at all. The last thing a team wants is, when they're going really well, to lose both batsmen who were in.
Come on, boys. We got this!
Impressive smell. Has really bowled well. He's been hitting the right areas consistently. Once again, a good delivery.
All three wickets going to spinners. We mentioned how effective they can be if they bowl in the right areas and at the right speed. These spinners, they bowl with consistency, more so this guy. Kusal Mendes just playing across the line unnecessarily.
Come on, batting in.
For once, that slot speed didn't work for Kusal Mendes. After 12, it's 109 for 3.
Runs from here on in will get them to 189. Candy Tuskers.
Only one.
Afridi gonna bowl out. None for 16 at the moment. This is his fourth over. But he's put the strangle on.
Can Brendan Taylor be a champion? Of course, we hope that you've picked your 11 champions on the My 11 Circle app. Your fantasy team for today. We hope that you score many points. Kusal Pereira would have got himself a couple, so too Kusal Mendes. Sweetly timed, finds the gap, and that will be a My 11 Circle champion shot.
He played this one with consummate ease. Brandon Taylor, an authentic cover drive. Just stayed on the leg stump, created that room for himself to hit the ball into the gap. He's not rusty, Brandon Taylor. Hit the air.
He'll have to take it deep. He can. He's got the boundary, then get off strike. Now he'll expect the same from the other batsman too.
Double side by wicket coming, boy.
Slower, flighted to the left-hander. Shoshide Afridi will fancy himself bowling to the right-hander. He often slides the ball in with the angle. Brings LBW into play. Taking the arms away from the right-hander as well.
And that right-hander is Brendan Taylor. His wicket here will really bring the Puthus kids on, the Kandy Tuskers innings. Inside out he goes, on the bounce. Jayan Jayasurya. He's not happy because he thought he could have attacked that ball and try and make that into a catch.
There was a chance to cut the angle. As a fielder, you've got to make that decision very early whether to run around or run into the ball. He chose running around. Didn't give himself a chance of taking a catch. Yeah, Shahid Afridi felt otherwise.
I thought so too. I understand what Shahid Afridi was feeling at that stage. He's bowled out. 13 gone, 118 for 3. Sandakan's gonna bowl out.
My 11 Circle MVP of the tournament, Ramanul Gurbaz at the top. He had a cameo today, should have sustained his innings. Russell Kusal Pereira, Gunaratna, and Dinesh Chandimal on that list. This time he gets the result. Reverse sweep with power, with placement.
And with ease. Not a lot of fuss about that stroke, but the result was sweet. My Circle 11 champion shot from Brandon Taylor once again.
Deflects it, hammers it. Gets into such a good balanced position from Zimbabwe, Brendan Taylor, and going back, say, 20 years. Andy Flower, he used to play that really well. Plays from Zimbabwe, tend to rely on that shot and play it so well. It puts bowlers off. It's tough for a captain to set a field when you're playing it this well.
Goes the other way, conventional sweep shot. As effective as the reverse sweep. Two boundaries already in the over.
No, I don't think that's a top edge. I think he intended it. He gets underneath it. Look at that, the way he turns the wrist, flick of the wrist to create that speed. That's brilliant. Brilliant skills from Brendan Taylor. My 11 Circle, champion shot.
He kind of hooked that ball with the bottom hand. And that's why it went finer and also cleared the fielder at short fine leg. Clever batting.
exchange in pace. Just made Brendan Taylor check that shot. He was leaning into it. Had to wait on that delivery for a long time. Batting to come. Gunaratna, Prasanna, Pereira. They can tonk it a long way. That's a fine stroke. Timed sweetly, made a good sound off the bat. And it goes for six. Ends the over on the high, 14 gone, 133 for three. Sweep shot has been an effective shot in this match so far. Kusal Mendes playing four sweeps, different lengths, losing his wicket off the last shot. That delivery a little bit wider, so a good adjustment by the bowler. Sandakan.
He has spoiled his figures somewhat. The last over expensive, 41. For two wickets.
Catch
it into the gap.
Pick up, batting up.
Zazai. Manages to intercept that. Sandakan.
Well done, brother.
For this game. Slightly wider and fuller. Just couldn't get underneath it, Kusal Mendes. Moment you go wider, you're looking to play the slog sweep, which is in the air. But if it was straighter, you have more control and you're looking to hit it along the ground.
Or you could even hit it over extra cover.
He could have gone the opposite way, yes.
He's asking for it,
but it's gone leg side-ish and it's running away. More runs. Leg buys it is.
Van Patan not playing today, injured himself in the first match. There was a fair amount of stump on show.
The angle would have taken the ball away from the next stump. It's falling wide of the crease. I think it was a good decision by the umpire straight away, shaking his head.
Now Afridi has a problem. 5 overs to go after this. Akhil Dhananjaya, Afridi himself, and Lakshan Sandakan have bowled out. Mohammad Amir has been good today. Not to pick up a wicket, but 2 overs for 8. So where does he go for the other 3? Mohammad Siraj went for 21 in his one.
Swept again. And the same result. Brendan Taylor, he's worked out exactly how to score runs in these conditions.